The thing is, the struggles that are currently emerging on a daily basis, actually, in most of these areas that are emerging at the moment, it was ANC strongholds, and all these people voted for the ANC government. And nobody were allowed here to come and campaign here for political votes or stuff like that. And I think because the people feel the ANC has really let them down, that's why people have chosen another direction and to choose another political home, such as the Anti-Eviction campaign. Even though we are not a political organization, we are a social movement trying to address the social needs of the people. But people also see the campaign as another political home, an alternative to this government. And that's why this campaign is going on growing on a daily basis, from strength to strength. Our idea wasn't at the first place to replace this government or find an alternative. It was just to raise the issues and get the issues addressed that affects the poor on a daily basis. The Western Cape Anti-Eviction campaign was started like in 2002 in January. It was six communities who came together originally who decided that we should put a stop to the injustices and the poor, the gap that are growing wider between the poor and the rich, the evictions that were taking place at the present, at that moment, the water cutoffs that were taking place right across the Western Cape. We decided then there as a community joined together and launched this anti-eviction campaign. And I think it was a good idea and it was a good initiative because up till now, the campaign is gaining great momentum. Even though the government see us as ultra-left, they just want to disrupt everything. We see it as an organization and a platform for the people where the needs can be addressed. Not as an organization that want to give the people another political party. Before we even want to think of a party, we want to think of coming up with a remedy for the policies that's killing our people, because most of our people don't have any knowledge about what the macroeconomic policies are all about, what the GATS agreement are, and what it means to them. But they do take the effects on a daily basis. They take the consequences of all these policies, and that's why the struggles are emerging on a daily basis in different areas, in different ways. It's in most places just instinctive, but as time goes, these struggles get linked together, and especially in the Western Cape Anti-Eviction campaign, we are linking the struggles together to form this formation and to really give the people the better life that the government has promised them. Because we have decided and we have seen that nobody's going to give our people a better life. We'll have to fight for it and we'll have to take back what is just rightfully ours. Because to evict people from their houses, it's like a terror attack. To cut off 10,000 people's water, it is genocide by the government. I mean, and the government gets away with it. So we're asking, who's pulling the strings of your government? And I think that is basically where the anti-American sentiment is coming in, where people in South Africa, in local areas, start asking themselves the questions, what are we going to do about the USA? Because the USA in itself are the instigators of all this suffering that's coming upon our people today. And most of our people, they know it. I mean, at first, in the apartheid era, we knew apartheid was the evil. Now we know that the capitalist system that America want to put in place across the world is the killer of our people, and that's why we are opposing it. And we will oppose it in any way we can. The thing is this, since we as the leadership of the Anti-Eviction campaign engage government and try to get the issues addressed, at first, with our first meetings and engagements with government and the ANC as such, Ibrahim Rasool and the provincial government, they were willing to launch and start this campaign with us and to take it further for a political purpose and gain of their own. And then we decided it won't work that way because we don't want the politics involved. So what happened is afterwards, when they saw that they couldn't buy us, they started to criminalize the issues that we are fighting around. Up till now, a lot of our people has been jailed, they've been in prison, they've been sentenced. A mother has even been sentenced for trespassing on her own property. I mean, this woman received a sentence of 2.5 years, and she's still serving it because she went back into her own house. And I think the government is very wrong by criminalizing the issue, making criminals of the poor, because I discovered in today's society and in our community and in this governing system, if you are not part of this government and you're poor, then you are a criminal and you are a nuisance to them. And up till now, they've managed quite well to victimize some of our leaders. Like for instance, Max Fonke, And they even had a case of intimidation against one of the other coordinators of the Western Cape, where we phoned this water department to ask them how many water has been cut off, and they charged us with intimidation because we wanted the information by them. And we think it's because the government can't find a solution to the problems, that they rather prefer to criminalize it and see that as a solution. But even though they want to go to the extremes to get us out of the way, the campaign don't exist out of the leadership or in the leadership. The campaign is the people on the ground that's suffering, the poor, the indigent, and those who can't access the system. So they can victimize us as the leadership for as much as they like. We will take it because what we're doing it in the interest of the people. And the suffering we endure is because of the people that we are willing to go through it. It is just another phase of that our people is going through in the struggle for freedom. Because if there's no equal justice, if there's no access to the economic structures and activities of this country, then our government can forget about getting this country right. Every day they go about and telling the people our economy is growing, the interest rate is just going up. I mean, if a province like the Western Cape that's so rich don't have petrol at the moment, our province have run out of petrol, and our government want to say that our economy is flourishing. I mean, they are misleading the people and other countries as well. So I think what we can expect of the government in future is whenever there's an organization like the Anti-Eviction campaign going to come up and want issues to be addressed, social issues, the government is going to criminalize them, and the government is going to make them off as ultra-leftists, like the government are doing with us as the campaign. Because the other day I had an interview on the radio, and just after the interview, Leonard Ramatlakane made a threat to me via the radio, and he said he promised us he won't leave me. So why they are doing this? Is it because of the inability to address the problems properly? Is it because of the corruptness of your government? Is it because of the multinational corporations that is pulling the strings of your government here? And we would like to know who is really running our country. Because how is it possible that our president can buy a 600 million rand jet while a person's water are being cut off here for 200 rand? I mean, it's madness if you look at it. And it tells you straight that this government don't care about the people. Even though the people voted for them, we had high hopes when we won democracy, but unfortunately, we didn't get what we voted and fight for. Because we realized too late, the leadership that we trusted was the one who sold us out.